As usual, because on that note, of the Ekiti Diocese Committee, Most Reverend Adelabu, shall be present. I'd love to welcome the Governor of Ekiti State, Emmanuel Bean, since October 2010, witnessed tremendous development in terms of infrastructure, in terms of women empowerment, in terms of youth, in terms of tourism development. We want to appreciate Mr. Governor and want to welcome him to this special occasion. Join me in acknowledging Mr. Governor of Ekiti State, Dr. Kaode Fayemi. You're welcome, sir. Distinguished, welcome the wife of with our women and children in Ekiti State for their empowerment and upliftment. We pray that God Almighty will continue to uplift her. Ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming the wife of Mr. Governor, Erelu Olabisi Fayemi. Welcome. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, our Ekiti House of Assembly remains the most prolific and hard-working House of Assembly in the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Mr. Speaker, sir, Right Honourable Dr. Adewa. Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome the Chief Judge, Ekiti State, an independent chief judiciary that we have in Ekiti State that is obvious and witnessed by all and sundry. The Chief Judge, Ekiti State, Right Honourable Justice Ayodeji Daramola, you're welcome, sir. Babi Otumba Ni Adebayo, you're very much welcome, sir. Adelabu.
and the governor designate. This is another thing that is very popular in the state, and particularly when we are talking about the free health mission in Ekiti state. May I welcome Dr. Dolapo Fashawe. You're very much welcome. We appreciate you. Mrs. Doyin Wanko, you're very much welcome. Mrs. Dayo Adelabu, you're very much welcome. And Mr. Dako Adelabu, you're very much welcome. We want to welcome all relations and friends that are here from
Modupe Adelabu was born on May 23, 1950 in Ekiti to Prince and Mrs. Samuel Adelabu. She attended class 2 at Ekiti between 1962 and 1967 and the Olivet Baptist High School on Yor between 1968 and 1970. She then posted to the prestigious University of Ife, now of Papa University. Okay, where she passed Bachelor of Arts education in history and religious studies in 1975. In 1981, Masters of Philosophy and Doctor of Philosophy in 1990. Professor Modupe Adelabu started her teaching career as a graduate assistant in 1976 in the Department of Educational Administration and Planning in Obafemi Awolowo University, where she rose to the post of professor on 1st October 2008. She served as head of Department of Educational Administration several times and also served as external examiner in some universities, including the University of Ibadan, University of Lagos, University of Ilorin, and the prestigious Ekiti State University here in Abuja. She served as council member of the Nigerian Teachers Institute, NTI, between 2001 and 2003. She was a council member of Christ International Divinity College, an affiliate of Acadia University, Canada, Erimon, Osun State, between 2005 and 2010. She was a member of the Planning Committee and the Implementation Committee of Joseph Ayodabalola University, JABU, between 2004 and 2005, of the Board of the State World Bank Assisted Poverty Reduction Agency between 2000 and 2003, the Administrator of International Repute, Professor Modupe Adeola Adelabu. Her major research area is in policy and personal issues in education, including teacher education, as well as poverty and gender-related issues in education, particularly in rural areas. Professor Adelabu is a prolific writer with over 40 articles published both in national and international journals. She has also authored many books. She has been a consultant for the World Bank, the Universal Basic Education Commission in Nigeria, the United Kingdom Department for International Development, DFID, and other international agencies. Professor Modupe Adeola Adelabu has also served as a resource person for UNDP, UNICEF, and UNESCO on various educational issues. For the state government reform in the education sector, Professor Adelabu is the recipient of the 2013 Quality Improvement Leadership Award, African Administration Icon, organized by the All African Students Union, ASU. She was appointed as chairman of the State Universal Basic Education Board in July 2011 until her new appointment. She was married to Prince Dichi Adelabu, and the marriage is blessed with four wonderful children. Your Excellency, I have the honor and privilege to present Professor Modupe Adeola Adelabu to this morning as Deputy Governor of the State of Anambra.
Professor Modupe Adeola Adelabu,
do solemnly swear,
do solemnly swear,
that I will be faithful,
that I will be faithful,
and bear true allegiance,
and bear true allegiance,
to the Federal Republic of Nigeria,
to the Federal Republic of Nigeria,
and that I will,
and that I will,
preserve,
preserve,
protect,
protect,
and defend the Constitution,
and defend the Constitution
of the Federal Republic
of Nigeria.
So help me God.
So help me God. Professor Modupe Adeola Adelabu,
do solemnly swear,
do solemnly swear,
That I will be faithful.
That I will be faithful.
And bear true allegiance.
And bear true allegiance.
To the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
To the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
That as Deputy Governor of Ekiti State.
That as Deputy Governor of Ekiti State.
I will discharge my duties.
I will discharge my duties.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Faithfully.
Faithfully.
And in accordance with the Constitution.
And in accordance with the Constitution.
Of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
Of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
And law.
And law.
And always.
And always.
In the interest of the sovereignty.
In the interest of the sovereignty.
Integrity.
Integrity.
Solidarity.
Solidarity.
Welfare.
Welfare.
Prosperity.
And prosperity.
Of the Federal Republic of
Nigeria.
That I will strive.
That I will strive.
To preserve.
To preserve.
The fundamental objectives.
The fundamental objectives.
And direct tips.
And direct tips.
And direct principle of state policy.
And direct principle.
Contained in the Constitution.
Contained in the Constitution.
Of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
Of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
That I will exercise.
That I will exercise.
That authority vested in me.
That authority vested in me.
As the Deputy Governor of Ekiti State.
As the Deputy Governor of Ekiti State.
So as not to impede.
So as not to impede.
Or prejudice.
Or prejudice.
The authority.
The authority.
Lawfully vested in the President.
Lawfully vested in the President.
Of the Federal Republic of
Nigeria. Of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
That I will not. Allow
that I will not allow
my personal interest,
my personal interest
to influence my official conduct,
to influence my official conduct
or my official decisions,
or my official decisions.
That I will, to the best of my ability,
that I will, to the best of my ability,
preserve,
resolve,
protect,
protect,
and defend the Constitution,
and defend the Constitution
of the Federal Republic of
Nigeria. Republic of Nigeria.
That I will abide,
that I will abide
by the code of conduct,
by the code of conduct
contained in the fifth schedule.
Contain the fifth schedule
to the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
That in all
circumstances,
I will do right
to all manners of people,
to all manner of people
according to law,
according to law,
without fear,
without fear
or favor,
or favor,
affection,
affection
or ill will,
or ill will,
that I will not,
that I will not
directly or indirectly,
directly or indirectly
communicate,
communicate
or reveal
to any person.
Any matter,
any matter
which shall be brought,
which shall be brought
under my consideration,
under my consideration,
or shall become known to me,
or shall become known to
as the Deputy Governor of Ekiti
State,
except as may be required,
except as may be required
for the due discharge of my duties,
for the due discharge of my duties
as the Deputy Governor,
as Deputy Governor,
and that I will devote,
that I will devote
myself,
myself
to the service,
to the service
and well-being,
and well-being
of the people of Nigeria.
For the people of Nigeria.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, between the government.
But there's no denying the fact that leadership has been genetically implanted in her. By coming from and being associated with three distinguished royal families in Ekiti State. But you know, our fathers, our forebears, our ancestors, as represented by all our royal fathers, especially by our father from the source, always tell us that even when you're born well, you still have to tutor yourself in the art of being well bred. There's no doubt that the woman of substance who has been appointed as our deputy governor today steps into light shoes. Our predecessor did extremely well. She struggled hard. She implanted herself in the mind of the Ekiti people through nothing but service. And there's no question that we've chosen somebody who would very well fit into those shoes. She did not ask for it. We did not pray for it, but that's how God wanted it. And we just have to accept that God knows best. And it is in this light that I really want to thank our party leaders for welcoming her with open arms, and our party members in Ekiti State for giving her wholehearted support. I also want to thank everyone for this show of love, solidarity, and support. My intention was for a very low-key swearing-in ceremony. Indeed, this event was supposed to take place inside the Executive Council chamber. I had to change my mind this morning, because I received pleas from far and wide. Because our people just wanted to acknowledge how much this occasion means to them. But what tilted this was when I received a message from Kabesi, His Imperial Majesty, that he was on his way from Ife to attend this swearing-in ceremony. Of course, what do I say to His Imperial Majesty? Not to come, that it was a low-key event, and that it would really not be particularly welcome in Ekiti. Of course, I couldn't say that. I am Papa's son, no doubt. But Papa is attending this event particularly for the woman who has been appointed the deputy governor, because she's been very close to Kabesi for a long time. You know, she's even though she's from Adelabu, she spent the greater part of her life in their resplendent headgears. Given what is expected. Ekiti is a very interesting place. Our people are very, very effusive in their love. But they are also very, very scathing in their criticism. I can assure you, Madam Deputy Governor, enjoy the honeymoon period. Because very soon, you will hear stories about yourself that you have never had in your life. You will hear rumors about yourself that will make you want to throw in the towel and resign. You will read if you're familiar with social media, particularly Facebook and all the others. You will read about yourself and you feel like crying. But the overriding faith that I know you have in God and your clear conscience will always stand you in good stead at all times. Don't worry about the rumors. Watch out your back. I used to be very sensitive to it in the early days. I'm still quite sensitive, but I think I've grown enough thick skin to be able to accommodate it. And in the initial days, I can see you coming to me that they've just written this about me. I don't know anything about it. Why are they doing this to me? But I also know that you are as tough as a nail, and you will do your best to just serve Ekiti people. That is the ultimate victory. Faith in God, service to our people, commitment to your work. I congratulate you and I wish you well in this job. Thank you. God bless you.
Honorable Adelabu, Adelabu,
The first judge, Justice Ayode Zarapada, my own brother and neighbor. The secretary to the government, the head of service. Please permit me to have this talk. I'm just learning. Members of the State National Assembly and members of the National Assembly, here present. Members of the State Ethical, Royal Fathers and their lovely honorees, Chairman of Boards and Parastatals, Body of Permanent Secretaries, permit me to come here to acknowledge once again in particular the presence of my father from Ileife. He came all the way from Ife this morning because of me. Kabezi, Eshewu, Eko Adefo, and my own blood father, the Ewe of Adejit. I think to Kabezi. I also want to acknowledge in particular and to thank God for my late husband, who actually was very dear to me. And that is why you have in our midst today his very loyal friend, General Kuni Ade, and Chief Pyro Kabezi. Thank you for standing in the gap. I welcome you. I want to also thank my children. They have been my pillars of support. I love them all. They are the only friends I have. Thank you, wonderful children. May God bless you. Sir, His Excellency, the Governor of Ekiti State. You have put so much confidence in me that I have nothing to do than to give you my 100% and total support. It's a great thing you've done in my life for putting my name on the world map. If not because of you, maybe my name would have just been restricted to the academic world. But now, everywhere in the world, anywhere you get to, you hear my name. And it's not by my power, not by my might, but through the help of God, through you. Thank you very much. At this stage, let me acknowledge, in particular, the very good work done by the late Deputy Governor Olufemi Lion, Adini, Olayinka. She worked very hard. She worked tirelessly. She worked tirelessly. And I promise today, I know where she is today at the bosom of the living God. She will be happy to see that the sister of ours are taking up the mantle. And I want to promise her that the work she has started, I intend to continue from where she stopped. Initially, it appears a bit difficult for you, for obvious reasons, and because of the challenges. But by the grace of God, I've never seen a cup half empty. I've always seen it as half full. And that is how I intend to see the challenges ahead. The road may be rough, but God is planting it for us. Yes. The hills may be high, but the Lord God will bring the hills down. Yes. There will be valleys. The Lord God Almighty will clear the valleys. Yes. Your Excellency,
so sick and pain, we will stand together. And we will move this day forward. I begin to see a new dawn. A better tomorrow. A better in this state. I begin to see a situation where we will begin to expose a state personnel. Very, very good. A mighty more people. I promise to serve this land without fear. Because I took this job not in fear, but in faith. And I believe that the Lord will support me.
Yeah.
I don't have much to say, that once again pledge my loyalty to Nigeria, to Ekiti State, but in particular to Iruka Miloya, Dr. John Karen Fire, who is here today. We will use Lord.
Yeah.
I can see him taking us higher, yeah, beyond the
Amen.
And I want you to mark my words. Very soon, we will all be in Abuja together.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
We will be present in the by inviting God once again into our midst. The government house in mind. How would the young men have been the young man in the end? I want to thank you for the opportunity to be brought to this program today. We want to thank government house for you. We thank you for them to be with him. May Almighty Allah continue to guide him aright. May Almighty Allah continue to support the man. Our Deputy Governor,